little over 4 years in the making, Clinton Township decided as a board, because of community encouragement, to put this together. The first thing I heard from almost everybody coming through the gate today is, I didn't think it was so big. And I didn't think it was so big. And I watched it being built. A lot of hard work went into it. Thank you, thank you, thank you to the volunteers. Thank you to those who helped us get money from Lansing. And thank you to the township board for putting the final $300,000 into this playground that will be here for decades to come. I'm glad it's big. I'm glad it's next to the splash pad. I'm glad it's next to what we're going to have all summer long with the concerts. I'm glad it's part of Clinton Township and now part of Clinton Township history. The township board member who did the most work on this is Paul Gillingham. So, Paul, I'm going to ask you to speak next, and we'll move on from there.
Thank you so much.
Yep.
So much. So what you see here today started with a mom, with an idea as to how we can create a place that is available for everybody to have the opportunity to recreate. I didn't know what an inclusive playground even was until I got a letter from Anne Marie Otoy. And Anne Marie said, this is something we ought to do. This is something that would be good for the community. We started putting together the research. And what we found is that while Clinton Township is home to 10% of the county's population, we are home to 20% of the county's population with someone in the family who has a disability. And so we had to ask ourselves as a board, are we serving all of the families in our community? And so when Anne Marie sent that letter, I said, let's meet. But what I also said is, this needs somebody. Hi, sweetie.
No, it's good.
Hi, sweetie.
It's good she's
yep.
here.
Hi, how are you?
It's a good time.
So we need to make sure that we have somebody who's driving this process and driving it with the passion that only somebody who lives the life, that experiences the difficulties every day being part of this. I said, so I'll drive it at the board level, but I need you to chair the committee. And she was a little bit nervous, but she stepped up in a very big way. And so what we did was we put together a committee of people and activists throughout our community that said, we're going to make this dream a reality. What you're looking at is the culmination of all of that coming together. And I so look forward to this opening up in the spring and this being the place where families have so much more opportunity right here in Clinton Township. So with that, let me introduce Anne Marie Otoy, the chair of our Inclusive Playground Committee and the driving force behind this. And she's going to introduce all of the people that put, well, maybe not all of them. I'm putting her on the spot. That's very difficult to introduce everybody and all the people, but certainly recognize our committee members. And this sneak peek is designed to build the excitement for when this opens in the springtime. So with that, Anne Marie Otoy.
That's kind of a big buildup. I started this project as a way to create awareness, to build connection, and to create community for a population of people who so often feel invisible and unheard, individuals with disabilities. At least that's the way that my family felt a lot of the times when my son was growing up, Zachary, who has disabilities, a rare genetic disorder, diagnosed at a young age. We were invisible to a lot of the community, or when we were noticed, it was because people were whispering and staring because of his behaviors that didn't mimic those of his typically behaving peers. Today, I'm in awe of the community that's already emerging just from beginning this project. From the partnerships with parents, families, the ARC of Macomb County, the Macomb Intermediate School District, the Clinton Township Board, Representative Denise Mentzer, Senator Veronica Kleinfeld, local businesses, community supporters, and most especially my committee, the Inclusive Playground Pals of Clinton Township, most of which are whom are standing here behind me today. Thank you so much. None of this would be possible without the partnership, dedication, and help of all of these individuals. It's really incredible. My greatest hope is that this playground helps sow seeds of awareness that grow into acceptance, understanding, and friendships that last a lifetime, that no one feels invisible. And when we see one another, we recognize the intrinsic value that is in each and every one of us. Too much for a playground? I don't think so. I think it's the perfect place to start.
All right. Now, what we want to do is, first of all, let me introduce the other board members that are here. Our clerk, Kim Meltzer, and Julie Matuzik, one of the trustees, Dan Kress, a board member. We have some of the people newly elected for Clinton Township, Mike Aiello, the incoming treasurer, and who else? Oh, Shannon King is out there, one of our incoming trustees who's currently on the Chippewa Valley School Board, along with Ken Pearl, used to be a board member of the committee, now a member of the Chippewa Valley School Board. So what we want to do now is we need to introduce Mary Bednar. She's our director of public services. And so when we started talking about this project, we knew we needed great staff people to help us drive it, but who can also share in the vision. Well, Mary's daughter is working on a degree in education, particularly special education. And so when she mentioned this to her daughter had tons of ideas and lend great value to it. And so her daughter's passion became Mary's passion. And so Anne-Marie and Mary, and where's our Rich Sinclair, is going to go around and talk about the different features in this playground, because some of them actually need some explanation. Like, what is this thing? So we're going to go through, and hopefully you're all going to help us build the excitement for when we open in the spring. Thank you so much for being here, and we'll turn it over to Mary and Rich and Anne-Marie. Thank you so much.
I'm Rich Sinclair from Sinclair Recreation, by the way, and we're the playground contractor who was fortunate to partner with the township to create this amazing space. And as someone who does this for a living and travels to more parks and playgrounds, not even in the state of Michigan, but throughout the entire country, please let me assure you that this is a world-class park that you all have in your community. This is significant. This is special. I think we all have things in our lives that we do. They're just the things that we do every day. In my life, that's playgrounds, but not very often, unfortunately, do we get to do things that are so spectacular and really impactful. So please take that to heart. This one is really special.